No, I have time. Hold it.
You call me out upon the waters, the great unknown, where feet may fail. And there I find you in the mystery, in oceans deep, my faith will stand. My soul will rest in your embrace, for I am yours, and you are mine. Your grace abounds in deepest waters. Sovereign hand will be my guide. Where feet may fail and fear surrounds me, you've never failed. come start now, and I will call upon your name and keep my eyes above the waves. When oceans rise, my soul will rest in your embrace, for I am yours and you are mine. Oh. And you
and my faith will be made stronger in the presence of Good morning. Welcome to Christ the King. And what a statement of faith that was. Spirit, keep us above the waters. Strengthen our faith. Thank you for your presence here today, Isabel, Izzy, Craig. I'm going to take a minute to introduce you. Maria gave me permission, so I'm not going to embarrass you too much. And welcome to your mom, Heather, also. You'll be returning to Coe College in Cedar Rapids, Iowa, as a history major. Thank you for that work. You grew up singing with Maria since the second grade, member of the children's youth choir, a song leader, and a cantor in your church. We so welcome you, Izzy, and your mom today to be with us. And I don't normally do this. We haven't started worship yet. Let's just show a moment of our appreciation for you and for Marty and Maria and our music ministry. How the power of music can take us just to this prayerful place that words sometimes can't. So thank you for sharing that gift with us. And thank you for being Jesus' hands and feet in the world through your music ministry. Welcome one of all to Christ the King Lutheran Church here in Delafield. I'm Pastor Jackie Cook, and I'm so blessed to be the pastor who ministers in and among and through you. Welcome all, welcome to those who continue to visit us online, and welcome to guests and visitors in this place and space. May you find this a place of prayerful worship and of support. We begin this morning with Psalm 33, and we use that as a dialogue, so please stand as you are able. Happy is the nation whose God is the Lord. Happy the people chosen to be God's heritage. The Lord looks down from heaven and sees all humankind. God sits firmly enthroned and watches all who dwell on the earth. God fashions all their hearts and observes all their deeds. A king is not saved by the size of the army, nor are the warriors rescued by their great strength. The horse gives vain hope for victory. Despite its great strength, it cannot save. Truly, your eye is upon those who fear you, O Lord, upon those who wait for your steadfast love, to deliver their lives from death and to keep them alive in the time of famine. Our innermost being waits for you, O Lord, our helper and our shield. Surely, our heart rejoices in you, for in your holy name we put our trust. Let your loving kindness, O Lord, be upon us, even as we place our hope in you. Amen. Our opening hymn is number 641, All Are Welcome. Thank you. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
Let us pray. Almighty God, you sent your Holy Spirit to be life and light of your church. Open our hearts to the riches of your grace, that we may be ready to receive you whenever you appear. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord.
Amen.
Is from Genesis. After these things, the word of the Lord came to Abram in a vision. Do not be afraid, Abram. I am your shield. Your reward shall be very great. But Abram said, O Lord God, what will you give me? For I continue childless, and the heir of my house is Eliezer of Damascus. And Abram said, you have given me no offspring, and so a slave born in my house is to be my heir. But the word of the Lord came to him, this man shall not be your heir. No one but your very own issue shall be your heir. He brought him outside and said, look towards the heavens and count the stars if you are able to count them. Then he said to him, so shall your descendants be. And he believed the Lord, and the Lord reckoned it to him as righteousness. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our second lesson is from Hebrews 11. Now faith is the assurance of things hoped for, the conviction of things not seen. Indeed, by faith, our ancestors received approval. By faith, we understand that the words were prepared by the word of God, so that what is seen was made from things that are not visible. By faith, Abraham obeyed when he was called to set out for a place that he was to receive as an inheritance. And he set out, not knowing where he was going. By faith, he stayed for a time in the land he had been promised, as in a foreign land, living in tents, as did Isaac and Jacob, who were heirs with him of the same promise. For he looked toward the city that has foundations, whose architect and builder is God. By faith, he received power of procreation, even though he was too old and Sarah herself was barren, because he considered him faithful who had promised. Therefore, from one person, and this one as good as dead, descendants were born, as many as the stars of heaven and as the innumerable grains of sand by the seashore. All of these died in faith without having received the promises, but from a distance they saw and greeted them. They confessed that they were strangers and foreigners on the earth. For people who speak in this way make it clear that they are seeking a homeland. If they had been thinking of the land that they had left behind, they would have had opportunity to return. But as it is, they desire a better country, that is a heavenly one. Therefore, God is not ashamed to be called their God. Indeed, he has prepared a city for them. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Holy Gospel according to Luke, the 12th chapter. Glory to you, O Lord. Jesus said, "Do not be afraid, little flock, for it is your Father's good pleasure to give you the kingdom. Sell your possessions and give alms. Make purses for yourselves that do not wear out, an unfailing treasure in heaven where no thief comes near and no moth destroys. Where your treasure is, there your heart will be also. Be dressed and ready for action and have your lamps lit like those who are waiting for their master to return from the wedding banquet so that they may open the door for him as soon as he comes and knocks. Blessed are those slaves whom the master finds alert when he comes. Truly, I tell you, he will fasten his belt and have them sit down to eat, and he will come and serve them. If he comes during the middle of the night or near dawn and finds them so, blessed are those slaves. But know this, if the owner of the house had known at what hour the thief was coming, he would not have let his house be broken into. You must be ready, for the Son of Man is coming at an unexpected hour." The Gospel of our Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. Please be seated. Jesus says, "Do not fear, my beloved followers, for your merciful and loving God delights to give you the kingdom." Oh, how I needed to hear this good news today. For over the last few weeks, the parables and the lessons from Luke's gospel have been challenging. And I confess that I find some of these ways that we're to live as disciples difficult and uncomfortable. Balancing contemplation and action, being rich toward God, persistent in prayer, and being spiritually prepared for an unknown time when Jesus will return. So then we have to sell our possessions, care for the poor, and live as if Jesus were coming back today. We live in this tension of the already but not yet reality. Jesus has come into our world to save us, but we've yet to experience the full blessing and the full enjoyment of God's kingdom. In the meantime, our world grows more uncertain and worrisome. When will war end in Ukraine? Tensions between nations lessen. When will prices decline to help struggling retirees and families? Violence and shootings cease. What has humanity learned since dropping an atomic bomb over Hiroshima? And since the 10th anniversary of the Sikh shooting, of the shooting at the Sikh temple in Oak Creek, when will judgment and hatred stop? Love overcome fear and division, all really be welcome in this place. When will God's children live as if the kingdom truly matters? So Jesus speaks these words to you and me today, here and now, as a promise. Do not fear, little flock, for it is your Father's good pleasure to give you the kingdom. Jesus will come again at an unpredictable time, like a thief in the night. Notice that mixed metaphor. Jesus, the thief in the night, stealing away that which pleases human beings and replacing it with that which pleases God, overturning our idolatrous treasures. Jesus will come again in great reversals, serving those who once served. Jesus will come again and make all things new, and that's a promise. Thus, what's ever going on in our world, inside of us, outside of us, in our towns, Jesus promises to be with you. Jesus teaches us not to be anxious, for it is God's joy to give you, that's a plural you, all of you, nothing less but the very kingdom of God. Now, the kingdom is not an earthly piece of land or territory like we think of it today. The kingdom of God is God's active reign that comes near in and through Jesus Christ, God's only Son. God's kingdom is the true treasure, which has the power to transform our identity into God's faithful children. Can you imagine how much God loves God's children and all of you? That God delights in giving you good gifts. So picture this. The clouds have wafted away, clearing the night sky above the camp, which is nestled in the woods overlooking a shiny glass waters on that sleepy inland lake. The crickets chirp an ode to the stately trees, and those city lights are but a faint memory to the flickering bright colors of the celestial light show. The good pleasure of your Creator God. Splendors to behold in nature. And can you imagine God's good pleasure to delight in you when you're enjoying such good gifts? When you delight in God's many gifts. To think that those same brilliant stars that you gaze upon are like the stars that Abram gazed upon on that starry night. Now, Abram trusted in God's promise that he would have a child, and we studied this in our women's Bible study. Yet Abram takes matters into his own hand and has a child by Hagar, Sarai's maid. And now the sun is setting at the end of the day as Abram speaks with his promise-keeping God. And then God shows Abram these stars. You'll have a son with Sarai. I picture Abram looking up and trying to count. Have you ever tried to count the stars at night? 1, 2, 10, 570, 5,000. Oh, I give up. Right? There's so many stars. And then God smiling as Abram realizes how many descendants God is truly promising. God's promises are bigger than our imagination. Furthermore, it's God's good pleasure to have reckoned faith to Abram as righteousness and to live in your hearts through faith. Faith isn't easy, is it? It's trusting in God since God is true to God's promises. The God that you have come to know in Jesus Christ is a promise-making and a promise-keeping God, but sometimes not in the time that we expect. Faith does not become an escape from the trials of this world. It's an understanding that what is being seen and experienced in this week, in this moment, in this year, in our lifetime is not all that there is. The chaos and the brokenness of the world do not define who you are or have the last word. It's trusting that you are forgiven and redeemed children of God, and that becomes a fortress against worldly distractions and anxieties about the future. Do not fear, little flock, for your future rests in the gracious power and promises of God. For living in a dynamic relationship with our promise-keeping God can bring serenity, joy, and peace that passes all understanding in the midst of troubles and circumstances. Countless times during tragedies, people have remarked to me, "If it weren't for my faith, I don't know where I would be." For it's God's good pleasure to comfort and assure in surprising ways. And you've experienced some of those ways through others, through Scripture, and through a sense of peace that comes to you when someone prays with you or you read Scripture. And I have this image in my hand of Jesus reaching out to us, grasping hold of our hands, and even holding us at those times. And faith grasps a hold of that promise. Moreover, it is God's good pleasure to give treasures that do not expire, everlasting treasures like God's sovereignty, protection, and the promise of Jesus' presence. To think that same God who created the world and all that is, the cosmos, the stars, that God attends to the ravens, the sparrows, the lilies of the field, is concerned about each and every one of you, each and every one of God's children. God delights in you and shows up in surprising and unexpected ways, today, here, and now. Can you think of a time where you encountered the graciousness of a promise-keeping God? I've been your pastor for nearly 2 years, and I've seen God show up so many times in this community, sustaining you through pastoral transitions, offering comfort and direction during the uncertain time of online gathering, adding a partnership with the Imbassini Parish in Tanzania, while still attending to our local partners like Veterans Serenity Inn and Reformation Church. I've witnessed God working in you as you grow in faith, as the women talk at Bible study on Monday mornings, and most of all witnessed God this morning, Izzy, thank you, in the music. You brought me back to a time where I would accompany youth groups, and I could picture some of those faces in front of me of those teens growing in faith, encountering our faithful God in many aspects of our life. Where has that happened for you? My dear friends in Christ, do not fear, little flock, for it is God's good pleasure to give you the kingdom. God delights in you. God is overjoyed in giving gifts to creation and humanity. For God's faithfulness surpasses the entire cosmos. This is the God who loves and cares for you. You worship a promise-keeping God who sent God's only Son, Jesus Christ, who loved and served others, and who died on the cross for overturning conventional norms. Jesus shows you the very heart of our promise-keeping God. Because of Jesus' death and glorious resurrection, you can live in hope today, and in hope that the kingdom of God comes near and among us. It's God's Spirit who brings you tender assurances in this anxious world. Oh, such blessed assurance, until Jesus returns again and makes all things new. And that's a promise God will keep. Thanks be to God. We sing together number 638, Blessed Assurance.
Oh, what a foretaste of glory divine.
Julie gets to stand with me. Donna, you need a microphone. And at this time, we will present our new members. Donna, if you could present them for us.
Sure. Thank you. I'm on. Okay. Good morning.
Good morning.
I'm Donna Finch. I'm a member of the membership committee, and on behalf of this committee and our entire congregation, we're so pleased and we're always so happy to welcome new members to our congregation. This morning, we're going to be welcoming Julie Schwartz and Al Latch, who's in the back there.
Everybody wave to Al.
Wave your hand. Turn around. You can see Al way back there. I'm going to introduce Julie first. Julie and her husband moved to the Delafield area about a year and a half ago from Mequonegal. They live on the lake. What lake? Negawicca. They live on Lake Negawicca. They winter in Florida. They both are retired, have two children who are grown and married, and have given them to grandchildren. Julie loves to cook and travel, and she's been very active since she's come to our church a while ago. She's helped with the spring cleanup. She's helped us with coffee hour. And when she shortly got here and I met her, she kept on saying, I need to get envelopes. I want to get some envelopes to donate. I thought that was just remarkable. We're so pleased to have her here. She didn't know when she came here that she already knew Pastor Jackie. Julie used to be the confirmation guide of Pastor Jackie's daughter.
And we survived.
A number of years ago. So we welcome Julie to our congregation, and now I'd like to introduce Al Latch. Al lives in Oconomowoc, but he used to live on Lower Namabin Lake for about 40 years. He and his wife have seven children. His wife sadly passed away recently, but all of their seven children were confirmed at the same time by Pastor Paul Christensen, who used to be a pastor here many years ago. Al is a sailboater, and he owns a home in Key West. So we certainly are very pleased to welcome both of them. Afterwards, we welcome everybody to the Upper Sanctuary. We have some beautiful cake up there. You can greet and welcome Al and Julie to our congregation. And if you have an opportunity, it would be great if you put a name tag on so they got to know who you are. Thank you.
We give thanks for the gift of baptism and for these people, one with us in the body of Christ, whom we welcome as new members into the life and ministry of this congregation. If you may please stand.
The whole church, let us confess our faith in the words of the Apostles' Creed.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the power of the Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He ascended to the dead.
On the third day he rose again.
He ascended to heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. In baptism, we are welcomed into the body of Christ and sent to share in the mission of God. We're called to live among God's faithful people, to hear the word of God and to share in the Lord's Supper, to proclaim the good news of God in Christ through word and deed, to serve all people following the example of Jesus, and to strive for justice and peace in all the world. Al and Julie, friends in Christ, you intend to continue in the covenant of your baptism among God's people in this place. If so, respond, I do, and I ask God to help and guide me.
I do, and I ask God to help and guide me.
And people of God, you promise to support and pray for these new members in their life in Christ.
We do, and we ask God to help and guide us.
So let us welcome these friends in Christ to this community of faith. We rejoice with you in the life of baptism. Together we will give thanks and praise to God and proclaim the good news to all of the world. So let us pray. We give you thanks for our new members, whom you have drawn to yourself by the love of Jesus Christ, and whom we have welcomed into this household of faith. Keep us closer together in your spirit, in the breaking of the bread and the prayers, and in service to others. We ask this in the name of Jesus. Amen. So let us welcome them with a round of applause. Welcome.
Thank you.
You can sit.
Trusting in God's extraordinary love, let us come near to the Holy One in prayer. Let your loving kindness be upon your church. Fill all who proclaim the gospel with your spirit. Equip your flock to speak your word of promise and hope in the midst of fear and uncertainty. Merciful God,
receive our prayer.
Let your loving kindness be upon your creation. Dwell among us and sustain our earthly home. In places of famine, provide nourishment. In places of plenty, fashion us to be good stewards of your bounty. Merciful God,
receive our prayer.
Let your loving kindness be upon your world. Be our helper and our shield in places torn by strife and violence, especially the Ukraine and Russia. Raise up courageous leaders to govern with compassion and justice. Merciful God,
receive our prayer.
Let your loving kindness be upon your children. Look upon all who wait for your steadfast love. Console those who grieve and embrace those who cry out to you, especially Dan, Eric and family, Todd, Donna, Tom, Anthony, Gerald, Hannah, Rita, George, Charlie, Sue, Mark, Pam, Adam, and Megan. Uphold those who grieve, especially the family and loved ones as Todd, as well as the family and loved ones as Mark, and also the Sikh community in Oak Creek. Help us to trust your promise and not be afraid. Merciful God,
receive our prayer.
Let your loving kindness be upon this community. Fashion our hearts to strive for the way of peace. Strengthen the outreach ministries of this congregation and all who care for those in need. Bless the work of the Evangelical Lutheran Churches in El Salvador and Tanzania and their bishops. In Bassini Parish in Tanzania, Serenity Inn, Family Promise, Reformation Lutheran Church, Lutherdale Bible Camp, All God's Children, the Mount Meru Coffee Project, and Outreach for Hope Congregations. Merciful God,
receive our prayer.
With thanksgiving, we remember all who have died in faith and now rest in you. As they place their hope in you, so strengthen us to trust in your promise of new life. Merciful God,
receive our prayer. Receive the prayers of your children, merciful God, and hold us forever in your steadfast love through Jesus Christ, our Savior and our Lord. Amen. Please be seated for our offering.
We pray for blessings, we pray for peace, comfort for family, protection while we sleep. We pray for healing, for prosperity, we pray for your mighty hand to ease our suffering. And all the while you hear each spoken need, yet love is way too much to give us lesser things. 'Cause 'Cause what if your blessings come through raindrops? What if your healing comes through tears? And what if a thousand sleepless nights are what it takes to know you're near? And what if trials of this life are your mercies in disguise? We pray for wisdom, your voice to hear. We cry in anger when we cannot feel you near. We doubt your goodness, we doubt your love, as if every promise from your word is not enough. And that we'd have faith to believe. 'Cause what if your blessings come through raindrops? What if your healing comes through tears? And what if a thousand sleepless nights are what it takes to know you're near? And what if trials of this life are your mercies in disguise? When friends betray us, when darkness seems to win, we know that pain reminds this heart that this is not our home. It's not our What if your blessings come through raindrops? What if your healing comes through tears? And what if a thousand sleepless nights are what it takes to know you're near? What if my greatest disappointments or the aching of this life is a revealing of a greater thirst this world can't satisfy? What if trials of this life, the rain, the storms, the hardest nights, are your mercies in disguise?
Let us pray. God of abundance, you've set before us a plentiful harvest. As we feast on your goodness, strengthen us to labor in your field and equip us to bear fruit for the good of all. In the name of Jesus, amen. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right to give our thanks and praise. It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, that we should at all times and in all places give thanks and praise to you, Almighty and merciful God, through our Savior Jesus Christ, who on this day overcame death and the grave, and by his glorious resurrection opened to us the way of everlasting life. And so with all the choirs of angels, with the church on earth and the host of heaven, we praise your name and join in their unending hymn.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest.
Blessed are you, O God, creator of heaven and earth. You rescued your covenant people led them all on journeys, and taught them by the prophets. You so loved the world that you gave your only Son, so that everyone who believes in him may not perish, but may have eternal life. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread, and he gave thanks, and he broke it. He gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat, this is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup and he gave thanks. And he gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sins. Do this for the remembrance of me." As often as we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim the Lord's death until he comes again. Christ has died. Christ has risen. Christ will come again. Pour out your Holy Spirit in this meal and make us one in the community of faith with all your people throughout the world. Glory and praise to you, O God, author of life, Word made flesh, power of the Most High, now and forever. Amen. Gathered into one by the Holy Spirit, let us pray as Jesus taught us. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Please be seated. Please come up to communion at the direction of the ushers. Everyone is welcome to come forward for the sacrament of communion. You may choose to commune in either way. Brian and I will be at either side. We will have a chalice that has grape juice and wine. The wine is the darker color. Grape juice is the lighter color. And we'll put a wafer in your hand. Just hold it open so we don't touch everybody's individual fingers. Your other option is to take an individual cup if that makes you more comfortable. So taste and see that our Lord is indeed good. Thanks be to God.
Jesus, Lamb.
May the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ strengthen and preserve you to eternal life. Amen.
Let us pray. Life-giving God, through this meal you have bandaged our wounds and fed us with your mercy. Now send us forth to live for others, both friend and stranger, that all may come to know your love. This we pray in the name of Jesus.
Amen. Amen. Does anyone want to come forward and help me bless the congregation? Peyton, you're coming? Yes. All right, I've missed you. I don't know when we started this, but this just makes my heart happy. You know how we do this, right? What? It's a blessing to receive a blessing from someone else, right? So extend your hand in blessing to us or to someone else around the room. Let's all bless one another. The God of peace bless you, comfort you, and show you the path of life this day and always. Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Our closing hymn is number 836, Joyful, Joyful, We Adore Thee. Be seated for some announcements. And as Bob cues up the slides, I have a couple that I don't want to forget. Afterward, you're welcome to come forward for healing prayers. Vicki as well as Sylvia will be here to individually pray with you if that's something you desire. Also, afterward, you're going to want to grab some cake for strength, but then the guys are going to need help in the great hall moving tables and such. We are connected so intrinsically to our community here at Christ the King, so we host voting, and that will occur on Tuesday, but they come in tomorrow to set up. So all hands on deck, grab a little cake and go and kind of help get some of that space cleared out and set up, and that would be much appreciated. We are still prayerfully looking for a new faith formation coordinator and trusting that God is preparing that person, especially for us. People tend to find places to work and places for their vocation by word of mouth. So spread that word among friends and family. God will find that right person for us. We're going to have to cast our nets a little wider and use our imagination. But that person is coming, yeah, just like Jesus coming a second time. We don't know when. In the meantime, we move forward with planning. Women's Bible study next time will be August 15th. No experience necessary. You don't have to have been in the Bible study before. We just welcome all of us as we are and have some really great discussions, so join us for that. Luther Dale's in Elkhorn, and they are having a quilt auction Saturday, August 13th. If you've never seen something like that, that's just wonderful. Go on their website for more information. 9 a.m. to 3 p.m. live auction begins at 10. Also coming up is Outreach for Hope, Family Ride, Run, and Walk. Outreach for Hope is the organization of congregations in the Milwaukee area that kind of band together that may need a little help with funding, some of those in our city. And we have fundraisers to help them and to really get to know one another as brothers and sisters in Christ. There are many opportunities. You can get a team together to walk. I've been hearing Maggie in the office talk about maybe getting a team to walk or ride. Also, I've just signed up to volunteer, so if volunteering interests you, see me and we can check our times together. Maybe we can do that together, and also donations. So we do have links to everything on our website. Maggie has made it convenient there for us. Any other announcements that I missed?
Go in peace. Love your neighbor. Thanks be to God.
Thanks be to God.